Hello everyone, welcome to Engineered. Today we'll be solving this problem related to engineering survey. And this problem is asking us to calculate the accuracy in the offset measurement. So it says the maximum angular error in laying the direction is 3 degrees. If the maximum displacement of the point on paper is same for both the sources of error, the accuracy in the offset measurement will be, and the 4 options are given, we need to select one of them. So let's see this figure. Now let's see this figure. In this figure, the maximum angular error in laying the direction is 3 degrees. So this angle is 3 degrees. This del alpha degree is equal to 3 degrees, right? So let's draw this figure again here. So if this is the triangle, sorry, this is quite off the figure, so let's draw like this straight. So this is B and this is A2 and this is A1 and this is del alpha, right? Del alpha degree. So how do you, and this is L, right? This is L from here to here. Due to angular error we measured L, right? So let's calculate A1 and A2. So what is A1, A2? And this is right angle triangle here is 90 degrees. So how can we calculate this A1, A2? So we can use sine del alpha degree equals to P is perpendicular is A1, A2 divided by N, hypotenuse is L, right? This A1, B. So A1, A2 equals to L sine del alpha degree. Similarly, this is from the angular error, right? A1, A2 is from angular error. Similarly, while measuring the length in the field, we also got some error. This particular error A1 A, and this particular error is basically dependent on the accuracy of the measurement, right? So let's say the accuracy of measurement is, accuracy is 1 in R. So let's say this accuracy is 1 in R. So what does it mean, 1 in R? So if we measure R distance, accuracy is, error is 1. So if we measure 1 distance, accuracy is 1 by R. And if we measure L distance, since this is L, right? This is L, right? This is L. So if we measure L distance, the accuracy, the error is L by R. Okay. So this is the thing. Now, so for this, for AA1, so AA1, we can write AA1 equals to, we can write what? We can write L by R. Okay. So this is the L by R. So again, see the question. The displacement of the point on paper is same for both the sources of error. So displacement A1 and A2 and this displacement, this particular displacement and this particular displacement are considered to be the same. So let's equate them. Okay. A1, A2, right? A1, A2 equals to A1. So what is A1, A2? A1, A2 is L sine del alpha, right? L sine del alpha degree. Okay. Equals to A1 equals to L by R. Now, okay, we can cancel L and L. So, R sine del alpha degree equals to 1. So, sine, let's write R here. And sine 1 by sine alpha degree, right? So the error is given as 3 degree, right? Here is 3 degree, right? Here is 3 degree. So we can put here 3 degree. If you calculate this 1 by sine 3, then it will be 19.1, right? So equals to 19.1 degree. So our accuracy is this, right? This is the accuracy. So this is 1 in R, right? 1 in R. So 1 in R is 19.1 degree. Okay, the option is 1 in 19 is the option. So we can take this as an answer. Or in some places you can also find this formula directly as R is equal to cosec del alpha degree. So you can directly apply this formula. Or similarly, in case you do not have any calculator or not allowed calculator in the room or examination hall, you can directly write R equals to, since the angle is very small, 3 degree, you can write 1 by del alpha degree. So it is 1 by del alpha is 3 degree, right? So this is in degree, so we need to convert this into radian. So we'll multiply this in by 5 and divide by 180. So it's like 180 divided by 3 into pi, right? So this is 60 by pi. So you can approximate this. So you can approximate this. So since pi is around 3, right? 3.14. So you can get answer 20, nearly 20. Since this is more than 3, so this has to be less than 20. Less than 20, this is more than 3. So our answer is quite less than 20 only. So let's check the options. So options is a few value less than 19 is, this is, 20 is 19, right? So we can guess the answer 1 in 19 if you don't have calculator in this case. So we can directly do this as well. Okay, that's all for this video. Thank you for watching.